I used to think that higher tyre pressure is always faster. In fact, when I started cycling, the only limits for me on my tyre pressure were how much weight I could bring to bear on a track pump and the safe limit printed on the tyre wall. Then I crashed a few times on corners in the wet and I realised that wasn't so smart. But this video isn't about the risk of slipping out or indeed puncture resistance, no. We are going to do a little experiment to see what tyre pressure is fastest on rough ground. Lab tests do actually show that for a smooth surface, higher tyre pressure does result in lower rolling resistance than low pressure. But the emphasis there is on smooth surface. Not many roads are actually totally smooth, and on a rough road, every little bump causes vertical movement of the bike and the rider, which is a waste of energy. Now consider a slightly softer tyre. That allows for some damping of the road roughness, reduces the vertical movement of rider and bike, and makes you more efficient. Brilliant! But if we take that too far, for example, if we go right down to one bar, well, then you have a really soft, sloppy tyre that is definitely not quick. So clearly, there is an optimum somewhere, and we want to try and find it. So here we have one rough 400 metre section of road, one bike, one power, one position, seven different tyre pressures. I'm going to start here and finish here, and see which one is quickest. Now, the scientific measurement of road roughness is known as the IRI, or International Roughness Index. I wanted to quantify the road roughness for our test, but apparently you need lasers mounted underneath the car, and they told me that the GCN budget wouldn't stretch to that, so I'm just going to qualify it as pretty darn rough. This is run one at 8.2 bar. Lesson from this experiment is that if you want to test your tyre pressure on a rough section of road, don't choose a piece of road that gets repaired halfway through your experiment. Now to the results. Well, I did see a slight decrease in time taken for the test run with decreasing tyre pressure, i.e. lower tyre pressure was actually a little bit faster. However, there was quite a lot of scatter in the results. And I can say that if I did this experiment again, I would choose a section of road maybe a bit longer with a few less potholes, because I'm not sure about the consistency of my testing. However, what I can say is that the lower tyre pressure felt so much more comfortable on the rough road, and I really felt like I was pedalling far more smoothly because I wasn't bouncing up and down as much. I'd like to emphasise that tyre pressure does depend on your body weight and the road conditions. For example, I weigh 50 kilos and my bike is pretty light, so I don't need a huge amount of pressure to resist snake bite punctures. If you're heavier, you will need a little more air in your tyres. Now, I have to say that experiment was not the finest I've ever designed, and quite apart from the fact that we didn't do enough test runs at each tyre pressure for the results to be reliable, I'd say that the course I chose was both too short to keep a consistent power and the time measured too short to draw any reliable conclusions from. But I think the point still stands. With tyres, harder does not always mean faster. So let's take a look at why. Well, faster means lower rolling resistance. What is rolling resistance? Let's look at what contributes to the loss of energy in a rotating wheel. Try to draw a circle. That's okay, actually, for a circle. Anyway, the main contributions to loss of energy are aerodynamic drag, the weight of the tyre, flexing in the tyre, and the road roughness. Now, the design and construction of the tyre have a major effect on three of these. So the aerodynamic drag mostly depends on the diameter of the wheel and the width of the rim and the tyre itself. Now, weight obviously varies a lot between different kinds of tyre, and the thickness and stiffness of the tyre wall are what affects how much it flexes. So there are big differences in rolling resistance between brands and models of tyres. But we're not comparing different tyres here. All we want to look at is a standard tyre, X, and changing the air pressure. So that means we can ignore the aerodynamic drag because, frankly, the difference in diameter of the tyre at different pressures is negligible, and we're also not looking at changes in weight. What does that leave? It leaves tyre flex and road roughness. So let's look at tyre flex first. Now, as a wheel rolls along, the section of tyre that's in contact with the road is compressed. That compression of the tyre makes the sidewall bulge out. This bulging of the tyre dissipates energy as waste heat in the material of the tyre. And the lower your tyre pressure, the more the compression of the tyre, the more the bulging, the more the flex, the more the loss of energy. So higher pressure means you go faster, right? Well, not necessarily, because of the road roughness. Now, when your tyre hits a bump, even a tiny, tiny bump like a piece of gravel in the tarmac, that exerts a resistive force on the wheel. Let's look at the force vector and break it down. This is a close-up of our wheel rolling forward. And we're going to look at the bit really close to the road. So the road and real close-up of our wheel and tyre. Now, in reality, we've got some compression of the tyre here, as we know. And we've got a little bump here. So the wheel is going this way, rotating this way. And this little bump here, the force it exerts on the tyre is at a normal angle to the tyre, obviously. So 90 degrees to the tyre. Now, as you can see, the force that this bump, let's call it a pebble, exerts on the wheel is not just vertical. It's actually at an angle to the vertical here. And that angle depends on both the size of your wheel and the size of the pebble. So the bigger the pebble, the bigger that angle, and the smaller your wheel, the bigger that angle, which is why in mountain biking, people often now use 29-inch wheels because the obstacles exert less of a backwards force. So let's break this force down. So the vertical component of this force vector, this bit here, the vertical bit, that's what you feel as uncomfortable jolting on your bike. The vertical up and down movement. And, well, it makes you uncomfortable. And that might well be slower because when you're uncomfortable, it's harder to pedal. I mean, if you can imagine riding on bare rims or a solid metal wheel, it'd be really hard to pedal just because of the jolting. But it's the horizontal part that we really don't want, because that horizontal force, F, call it H for horizontal. So clearly, if any given road, there is an optimum tyre pressure, something that is between too hard and too soft. Let's call it the Goldilocks tyre pressure. But how do we find out that perfect tyre pressure? Well, that depends on tyre width, the total mass of you and your bicycle, and just how rough the road really is. And of course, when you go out for a ride, you might ride on many different surfaces. So you need to take a balance of the roughest and the smoothest roads you'll be riding on. Now, there are plenty of tyre pressure charts out there, which I would encourage you to look up. When you're looking at one of these charts of tyre pressure, remember that your weight on a bike is not normally evenly distributed. Most people and most bike geometries mean that you have about 60% of your weight over the back wheel and only about 40% over the front wheel. And of course, it does depend on your position on the bike and the geometry. But that means that you normally need to have a higher tyre pressure in your back tyre than in the front tyre. Now, one other thing that you clearly have to take into consideration is the possibility of snake bite punctures. So clearly, if your tyre is totally compressing over every bump and you're likely to get a snake bite puncture, then your tyre pressure is definitely too low. Hopefully this video is at least a little bit interesting and it helps you to see why Harder tyres, not always faster. Perhaps you will even be inspired to design and run your own experiment on tyre pressure to see which pressure is fastest for you. But of course, it does depend on the road conditions. Why not let us know in the comments how you get on if you run an experiment, give us a thumbs up if you liked it, and if you would like to see a little bit more about tyre pressure, why not check out Simon's excellent video about tyre pressure by clicking down here.
Quiet now, Granny's talking. Right,
behave yourself, all right? Won't tell you twice.
Right. Magnet? So exciting.
That's how rough the road is. Why are truck pumps always so tall? That's almost as tall as me.